software, the solution for humanity. طابت لياليكم بشهر الخير والغفران رمضان 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 May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness Ramadan Ramadan Ramadan
Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and welcome to another blessed night Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأولين والآخرين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد Brothers and sisters, let's welcome our studio guest for Blessed Night program and inshallah عز وجل will indulge immediately into the explanation of few verses of the 11th part of the Quran. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh Saeed Al-Qadi from the UK. Jazakallah khairan for joining us.
Barakallah alaikum. Salam, Sheikh Muhammad Saleh.
And Sheikh Ibrahim Zidan, thank you so much for joining us. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
Now, Sheikh Saeed, in verse number 103 is a comment on verse number 102, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا وَصَلِّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ صَلَاتَكَ سَكَنٌ لَهُمْ Take, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from their wealth, sadaqa, charity, تُطَهِّرُهُمْ, to purify them with it, وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا, and to sanctify them with it, وَصَلِّ عَلَيْهِمْ, and pray for them as a result of that, because your prayer is a means of security for them. وَاللَّهُ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ I would let you, inshallah, comment on the ayah and teach us a few lessons out of it.
Allah musta'an. Jazakallah khair, Sheikh Ahmed. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Well, first of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he should take from our wealth a charity with which Allah ta'ala will purify us. And you might ask yourself, how can a charity purify the person? It purifies the person from an illness or a disease that we might have. Because we all tend to love dunya. And that's what the Quran said, Anyone who is saved from his desire. Indeed, they are the successful ones. So, Allah Ta'ala...
The self-desire you mentioned here is stinginess.
Stinginess, yeah.
The love to possess.
Greed and...
And the hate exactly. to spend.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Being mahzar and being stinginess, yeah. So, this sadaqah or donating in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will purify us from this illness and this disease, which is loving money, being miser or greedy. So when we do that, of course, we are purifying ourselves. When we give in Allah's sake, we are purifying ourselves. We are perfecting our souls. Then another issue that Allah mentioned there as well, وَصَلِّ عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ صَلَاتَكَ سَكَنٌ لَهُمْ And pray upon them or make dua for them. Because that will give them peace of mind. Some ulama said that it is recommended that the imam, whenever he receives any charity from anyone, to encourage him and to make dua for him and say, may Allah accept it from you, may Allah multiply your provision. So it's a good thing that we can as well implement, inshallah ta'ala.
And this ayah was revealed as a follow-up to verse number 102. Because Abu Lubabah and those who were along with him, when they tied themselves and they said, we're not going to untie ourselves until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts our repentance. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave them and accepted their repentance, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, you just mentioned that the love of the dunya and its position. So they said, look, Ya Rasulullah, what kept us behind is our dunya. So we want to give it away. They brought their entire wealth and they said, Ya Rasulullah, I'm stripping myself of my wealth. It's all for the sake of Allah. So the Prophet ﷺ abstained from taking it. He doesn't want to take their entire wealth. But by the way, before the battle, Some companions donated their entire wealth in order to support that cause, such as Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him. And the one who was always competing with him and was always beaten by Abu Bakr was Umar ibn al-Khattab, who donated half of his wealth. I guess it is very hard to comprehend somebody is writing a check of 50% of his position, of his entire position. So he comes to the Prophet ﷺ happy. The Prophet ﷺ asks him, "Ya Umar, that's too much. What did you save for your family?" "Ya Rasulullah, I saved similar to that." "What about Abu Bakr al-Siddiq?" "Ya Abu Bakr, what did you save for your family?" "I saved for them Allah and His Messenger." This is really beyond imagination. I don't think one can really contemplate the idea of giving away his entire wealth. And by the way, it is not recommended. But during these circumstances where Muslims were in desperate need for fund,
it's the certainty.
Yaqeen.
Yaqeen is one of the early generations of Islam. Mm. He gave a very good example to it. If you have two houses and you're taking money from one house to build another, nobody would say that you're wasting your money. The same thing when a believer would give for the sake of Allah, he's building the eternal one, which is in the hereafter. But there's another point, if you don't mind, with the way of the Quran of exposing the different categories of people, like what we mentioned, the companions and the hypocrites and so on. This is a great mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us to witness and to see which group we want to be with, that we want to be like. And this is one of the ways, like in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, so that the human being will choose, I want to be like this group or that group. And that's a great mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that all the human beings are being exposed in the Quran.
Yeah, correct.
For people to choose.
Another thing which is, I guess because we grew up reading the Quran, memorizing the Quran, hearing a lot about the promises of giving the multiple reward and so on, we got used to it versus some people who were exposed to that the first time. So we need to pay attention to when we deal with beginners or with people who are exposed to the Quran for the first time, to take it easy on them because they don't know. I remember giving a khutbah in the States, and there was a huge project, an Islamic center and a school and so on, and it needed some support and funds. So this guy came after the Jum'ah and said, "I heard you saying in the Jum'ah that Allah promises if I give $1,000, Allah will give me 10,000. Do you promise so? If I write a check of 100,000 now, Allah will give me 1,000,000. I said, "Look, this is not my promise. This is Allah's promise." And guess what? The 10 times more is the least. This is the least reward. Al-hasanatu bi'ashr amthaliha. This is the least reward. So Sheikh Ibrahim talking about striking deals with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and paying very little and getting much and a lot. In verse number 111, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about a very special kind of transaction, very special deal. The package is, you sell something, you get for it the price, al-jannah. The thing is, your own self. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمْ الْجَنَّةِ. Sheikh Ibrahim, please.
As you clearly and beautifully explained it, it's a trade. We live a life that people are in state of trading with one another. And when it comes to the purpose of our life, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from the believers their own selves, because it's all owned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person chooses to give his life and to give his wealth and to give everything that a person has for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for what is the return is Jannah, it is worthwhile for a person to do such a trade. And as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the authentic hadith, that the commodity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is expensive, and the commodity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Jannah. No eyes have seen, no ears have heard, no hearts have ever imagined. And for what? For something that is so easy and simple for the believers when they give their life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the jihad, fighting in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is there with salam al-Islam, is the highest level. Why? Because a person would reach such a level that his own self becomes nothing when it comes to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Because we were talking about giving in a charity,
right,
a handful of dates or a mountain or 50% of your wealth or your entire wealth. But we're talking about Now giving everything, giving your own self.
And if a person, shaitan would whisper, given oneself, that means I'm going to lose myself.
Yeah.
It's the total opposite.
Exactly.
He would win everything. Exactly. He would never lose anything. Mm-hmm. Never.
وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ
أَمْوَاتٍ
بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ
right.
Don't you think that those who died for the sake of Allah did? Rather, they're alive, they're with the Lord, and they're being provided.
Right, and everybody will die anyway.
And inshallah, we'll be back, so stay tuned.
Ramadan, Ramadan. Stories of glories. Often that three. Fought the pangs of poverty by selling gowns at 13. His blindness did not stop his unquenchable thirst for knowledge. Propagated virtues, prevented vice with decisions unchallenged. He is Sheikh Abdul Aziz bin Abdullah bin Baz, former Grand Mufti of Saudi.
The glorious Quran is basically a book of guidance to man in areas that cannot be clearly addressed by man, such as the area of faith, acts of worship, the moral code, and the code of transactions with others. The glorious Quran contains more than 1,000 cosmic verses. These verses come in the context of testifying to the supreme nature of the Creator, who has created everything, is capable of annihilating what He has created and reconstructing and resurrecting it. These verses have been proved to be scientifically correct. So join me, Professor Najjar, in this program, Islam and Science, only on Peace TV.
The absolute truth, verified by the present science and the science of all time. Join Dr. Zaghloul An-Najjar in Islam and Science every Tuesday at 4 p.m. and repeat telecast at 2:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
We are not addicted to dawah. Addiction implies a short-term fix. One doesn't need to get into the zone to talk about Islam. You do dawah because it is a natural result of your commitment to Allah. If you don't talk, people are going to walk. The most effective combination in the propagation of true Islam is found in Dawah Ilallah. Join me, Arif Islam, as we go through Dawah Ilallah only on Peace TV.
Follow the tips to make the task of Dawah result-oriented in Dawah Ilallah. Every Sunday, Tuesday and Thursday at 11:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 6 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
Ramadan, Ramadan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and welcome back. Okay, since this is the last segment, without wasting any further time, Sheikh Saeed. Verse number 112 talking about the traits of those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala struck the deal of purchasing their souls from them and giving them the price of paradise. At-ta'ibuna al-'abiduna.
Allahu Akbar, may Allah bless you. You gave me only 1 minute, which is very difficult to describe the sifat. But I will mention the first one, which is the ta'ibun. We all fall in sins. We all commit sins. That is the nature now as human beings to fall in sins. But the difference between the believer and the hypocrite is that the believer, whenever he falls in a sin, he repents to Allah in a certain way. And he doesn't wait. As soon as he falls in the sin, repents to Allah in a certain way. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا إِذَا مَسَّهُمْ طَائِفٌ شَيْطَانٌ Those who are pious. Whenever the shaitan causes them to fall in the haram actions, they will straight away repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, returned back to him. And one of the companions said, Ya Rasulullah, quickly, I'll summarize, he said to him, Ya Rasulullah, give me an advice, for with I won't be in need of any more advices. He said to him, قُلْ أَمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ فَمَسْتَقِمْ Say, I believe in Allah Ta'ala, and then steadfast. The ulama said, steadfast means here that whenever you fall in a sin, repent to Allah, because you will fall in sins. التائبون, first of all, every time you fall in a sin, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. العابدون, those who truly worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from their hearts, and they are sincere towards Him. السائحون, those who go out in the...
To seek knowledge, to give da'wah, or to... For the sake of Allah.
Another as well, translation of السائحون is that they are those who fast. الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر, which is known to forbid the evil and to enjoy the good with your دعوة. With your community, with your family, with your self as well.
والحافظون لحدود الله.
والحافظون لحدود. Here we stop whenever you see Allah's boundaries, Allah's laws, you stop, you don't breach them at all, you don't violate them. And you try that you enjoy this on people as well.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says repeatedly in the Quran, for instance in Surah Al-Baqarah, تلك حدود الله فلا تقربوها. تلك حدود الله فلا تعتدوها. Then he warns, ومن يتعد حدود الله فأولئك هم الظالمون. In Surah Al-Talaq, ومن يتعد حدود الله فقد ظلم نفسه. These are the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Never cross them. Never go near them. Similar to فلا تقربوها كذلك يبين الله آياته للناس لعلهم يتقون. Sheikh Ibrahim, you wanted to add something?
The issue of صدق, of truthfulness, this is what صدق is. As the ulama, they say, the sincere intentions, but then you have to do the best you can.
These practices. That is,
that's right.
Jazakallahu khairan. Okay, Sheikh Ibrahim, verse number 113. If we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most merciful, and His mercy is so vast that it covers everything. وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ As Allah said in Surah Al-A'raf, My mercy has encompassed everything. But what is this? مَا كَانَ لِلنَّبِيِّ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن يَسْتَغْفِرُوا لِلْمُشْرِكِينَ وَلَوْ كَانُوا أُولِي قُرْبَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُمْ أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ Who will not be eligible for Allah's mercy while it is very vast?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear in the Quran that those who die in the state of disbelief after the matter has been made clear to them and the message had reached them, they don't have an excuse, they will be in the hellfire forever. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the believers from making dua, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for mercy for those who died in the state of disbelief. And that's where the truth and the justice of Islam is.
And because some people would claim, oh well, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Prophet Abraham, promised his father, said, La astaghfiranna lak, I shall ask for forgiveness for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the following ayah to explain what kind of istighfar was it? Because Ibrahim alayhi salam was one of ulul azmi min al-rusul, and he's the father of the prophets. The ayah says, وَمَا كَانَ اسْتِغْفَارُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ لِأَبِيهِ إِلَّا عَمَّ مَوْعِدَةٍ وَعَدَهَا إِيَّا تفضل.
فَلَمَّا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ أَنَّهُ عَدُوٌّ لَا يَتَوَرَّأَ When the matter was very clear to Ibrahim alayhi salam.
So he promised him first.
Right.
When he came to fulfill the promise.
Right. He find out that he is an enemy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He freed himself and distanced himself from him.
He disowned his father.
Right. And that's the truthfulness when the iman, when the faith is in the heart. That even the most beloved to you, when it comes to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for the believers, the love of the deen, the love to protect the deen is more valuable to them than even the closest people to them.
And that's the real worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Nuh alayhi salam begged Allah's mercy and forgiveness to cover his son, he said, Rabbi innabani min ahli, he's my son. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's reply was very strong. He said, Nahu laysa min ahli. Not anymore. He does not belong to, even though he is your biological son, but he died in a state of disbelief. I hope this meaning and ma'na is very clear in the mind of the
audience.
He did bad. And the worst deed is to disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal'a'adhu billah. So another chance for every person who is thinking about the deen, or he has a beloved person who's not in a state of Islam, convince these guys, tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy covered everything, even the disbelievers in this life. Because if Allah was not merciful to them, He would have taken them out of the face of the earth. They insult Allah, they accuse Allah, and no one is more patient than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tayyib, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in verse number 24, Sheikh Saeed, tells us this life does not really deserve all of this hassle and struggle and disbelief.
Subhanallah.
It is short and brief. And it is extremely short and brief. It is not worth it. And we see that cycle of life in everything around us. New people are born.
SubhanAllah.
People are dying. And death does not recognize age, nor gender, health, or strength, or sickness, or weakness. فَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيحٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ عِلَّةٍ فَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيحٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ عِلَّةٍ وَكَمْ مِنْ سَقِيمٍ عَاشَ حِينًا مِنَ الدَّهْرِ وَكَمْ مِنْ صَغَارٍ يُرْتَجَى طُولَ عُمْرِهِمْ وَقَدْ أُدْخِلَتْ أَجْسَادُهُمْ ظُلْمَةَ الْقَبْرِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like always, gives us a parable of how short and brief, how insignificant in this life. In one hadith, the Prophet says, if the life of this world and all what it contains was even worth a wing of a fly or a mosquito, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not have provided a sip of water to a disbeliever. It's worth nothing. So in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in verse number 24 in Surah Yunus, إِنَّمَا مَثَلُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا إِنْ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ فَاخْتَلَطَ بِهِ نَبَاتُ الْأَرْضِ. Of course, there is a similar ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, فَأَصْبَحَ عَشِيمًا تَذْرُوهُ الرِّيَاحُ. But here it says, مِمَّا يَأْكُلُ النَّاسُ وَالْأَنْعَامُ حَتَّى إِذَا أَخَذَتِ الْأَرْضُ زُخْرُفَهَا وَزَيَّنَتْ وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا أَنَّهُمْ قَادِرُونَ عَلَيْهَا أَتَاهَا أَمْرُنَا لَيْلًا أَوْ نَهَارًا فَجَعَلْنَاهَا حَصِيدًا كَأَن لَّمْ تَغْنَ بِالْأَمْسِ كَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. شيخ سعيد تفضل.
بارك الله فيك حمزاك الله خير. الله سبحانه وتعالى is describing this worthless life, this worthless world that we are living in. And even if you compare it in mathematical science, we find that how long can I live in this world? How many years? 70 years?
The actual life?
Yeah.
If we look at the actual life, approximately 20 years.
The actual life, 20
years. Sleeping, eating, answering the call of nature, and until the age of puberty, you're wasting. If a man lives for 60 years, the actual lifetime
is 20 years.
20 years.
So in mathematics, any number, be it 20 years, be it 60 years, be it 100 years, be it 1,000 years, be it whatever, any number, divided by the hereafter, which is infinity. Any number in mathematics divided by infinity, the answer is zero. So the ratio between this life and the hereafter is zero.
Sheikh Saeed.
I did a math degree. That's what we have in the hadith, that the comparison between this life and the hereafter is like dipping your hand into the water or the ocean, and then pull it out and see what stays in your hand from the water. This is life, this world.
And nothing, because there's already rain that already will fill more than what you took.
Talking about dipping, there is a hadith. If we say, who is the wealthiest person nowadays? Of course, when people say Bill Gates, let's talk about Qarun, whose treasures were put in boxes and were locked down. And the keys to those locks were put in boxes that it would burden 10 people to carry the boxes of the keys to the boxes of the treasures.
SubhanAllah.
And that person who lived the most luxurious life, as in the hadith, يُؤْتَى بِأَنْعَمِ أَهْلِ الدُّنْيَا. The most delighted person in this life, the richest person. You were talking about dipping. And you will be dipped once, where?
To the...
Because مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فِي الْآخِرَةِ. Because he lived the most luxurious life in this life, but he was a disbeliever, or he deserved to be punished. And he will be dipped once in fire. Then he will be taken out and he will be questioned. Allah will ask him, عَبْدِي, did you ever enjoy your life? Did you ever have fun? He say, I swear I have been suffering ever since you created me. And the poorest person, but he was a believer, who was full of tests and trials, sickness, perhaps lost his family or whatever. So his life was full of misery and suffering. But he was patient. When he dies and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admits him to Al-Jannah or dips him once into heaven, then take him out and ask him, Abdi, did you ever experience any hardship or difficulty? Did you ever have any suffering in life? What would you say, Sheikh Ibrahim?
Say, so, yeah, I never had any suffering in my life. Just because of one
أنا في النعيم منذ خلقتني. I swear I have been enjoying my life ever since you created me. So that wipes out those 20 or 40 or 60 years of...
Sit away. sit away.
Some people they say only 20 years a person would have everlasting misery.
Yeah.
For just 20 years. To answer that clearly, to show the status of the heart. Please. For these 20 years, this disbeliever had the intentions that if he would live forever, he would stay a disbeliever forever. So the punishment is because of that state of the belief in the heart.
In addition to, he was not tricked.
Right.
He was told. Look,
right.
By the end of the year, there is final. So a loser, if you give him an extension, another month, he would do nothing. If you give him another month, because he was not planning to do any good. But a person who is active and proactive, and he knows exactly his goal and object of this life, so he acts upon it. I would like to end up in the last half minute with verse number 25. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُوا إِلَى دَارِ السَّلَامِ وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَى صَرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. What does Allah call us unto? He calls us unto the home of peace, paradise, دار السلام. And He invites to it whomever He wills. This is the invitation of entering Jannah. But as far as the guidelines, the signs, paradise is from here, it's for everyone. This sign was shown to Aba Jahl. This sign was shown to Pat Robertson. This sign was shown to every person who's living or died before. Those who did not see the signs or the guiding signs would be exempt. But everyone is informed. Every nation Allah has sent to them messengers. وَإِن مِّنْ أُمَّةٍ إِلَّا خَلَى فِيهَا نَذِيرٍ. But who will enter it? As the Prophet ﷺ said, all my ummah shall enter paradise, except for those who refuse. Illa man aba. Companion said, what? And who refused to enter heaven? He said, man ata'ani dakhala al-jannah, wa man asani faqad aba. Whosoever obeys me, he chooses to enter heaven. And whosoever disobeys me, he chooses not to enter heaven. Wa yahdi man yasha'u ila siratin mustaqim. And Allah guides whomever He wills into the straight path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast on the straight path. Brothers and sisters, we came to the end of tonight's program of Blessed Night. And until another Blessed Night, I leave you in the care of Allah and spend a blessed time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. طابت لياليكم بشهر الخير والغفران طابت لياليكم بشهر الخير والغفران رمضان 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 May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness. May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness. May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness. May your Ramadan nights be blessed with welfare and forgiveness. Ramadan, 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 Ramadan.
Thursdays provide.
In Britain, we are facing one big problem, that are you Muslim or British?
The space to talk.
In India, back home, they ask, are you a Muslim first or Indian first? And we Muslims should know how to reply, how to turn the tables over.
The place to knock.
Why Trinity cannot be regarded in that sense, Father, Son and Holy Spirit?
The opportunity to ask.
But even if we agree that what the Christians say, that he was crucified, so if Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, died for 3 days, who controlled the world? That means even God died?
The freedom to unmask.
So there are various ways which we can prove the argument to be wrong.
Let's meet Dr. Zakir every Thursday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.